capacity building training to the STPRI members. You see, the master trainers training program has been designed to be provided in two batches over a period of next 10 days. And the master trainers in turn will provide capacity building training to more than 30,000 STPRI members in batches. We also will provide training along with the STPRI members, tribal youths, NGO representatives, and selected SHG members in next 4 to 5 months' time at Gram Panchayat level in physical mode. It is hoped that this initiative of the Ministry of Tribal Affairs and ST and SC Development Department will be extremely beneficial in enhancing the capacity of the STPRI members and enable the tribal people of the state to take benefit of availing the existing schemes and programs meant for them. I wish the master training program, which is the first step towards providing capacity building training to all the STPRI members of the state, will be extremely productive and achieve its desired objectives. In fact, Odisha is the first state in the entire country to start the initiative on a saturation mode. This entire initiative has been funded by MOTA, Government of India, to SCST RTI, Government of Odisha, under ST and SC Development Department. Well, I once again welcome all the dignitaries present here today in the inaugural session and extend my sincere gratitude to each one of them. I also extend my special gratitude to all the resource persons who have taken pains to develop the contents of the training and have kindly agreed to extend their support in the training program. With this, I again extend a very warm welcome to one and all.
Thank you, sir. Now I would request Dr. Narmanjit Kapoor, sir, Joint Secretary MOTA, to kindly deliver the inaugural address and share the objectives of the STPRI training program.
Good morning, everybody. Principal Secretary Odisha, Ranjana Chopra Madam. Director TRI, Dr. Rota. Poonam Guha, Director SCST Welfare. Resource persons. I must compliment Odisha team, Principal Secretary Odisha and TRI Odisha for taking this another important initiative, which was launched in Odisha only last year. As Ota Sahab briefed, we have developed a module with the help of UNDP, TRI Odisha, IIPA, and I'm very happy to inform that large number of NGOs, they are already joining in this program. Art of Living Foundation, they have started this activity in Jharkhand as well as Chhattisgarh. One important point which I want to bring in the knowledge of the resource persons as well as master trainers is that this program should be made interesting. It should not happen that hum log unko sirf kuch presentations dikha rahe hain. I have already told Ota Sahab and UNDP that you have to make some interesting videos, pamphlets, short booklets. That type of material has to be prepared so that when you go to the Panchayati Raj institution representatives, you are able to connect with them. And as far as possible, you have to speak in their language. Even the material has to be in their language. Second important point which I want to tell is we also have to develop the database of the master trainers, the trainees, as well as the resource persons, so that in the times to come, this database will be useful not only for Odisha, but these trainers can be utilized in other parts of the country also. Based on the learnings from this program, because this is for the first time that such a large trainers are being persons are being trained. So based on the learnings, we intend to extend this program in other parts of the country. So outcome of this program is very, very important for us. So I will request Ota Saab to constantly give us feedback, what are the learnings and how the people are taking these programs. Last but not the least, we have also done the gap analysis of 1,17,000 villages, which is available on a dashboard. So whenever the trainers as well as the persons who are going to the fields and villages, they must see the gaps which are seen in the portal, whether they are actually existing and what plans we can make to fill these gaps. From 1st April, we are also planning to launch Pradhan Mantri Adarsh Gram Yojana. So there we have identified 30 indicators which will be wherever the gaps are there, to saturate these indicators with the resources from STC component as well as the funds available with the ministry. So this program, training of Panchayati Raj Institute representatives, will go a long way in making their development plans also. With these words, I once again congratulate Dr. Ota and Madam Chopra and the entire team who has been working very hard for last 6 months to make this program successful. All the best, Dr. Ota. Thank you.
This program a success, and as sir you have directed, we are working on collecting the database and compiling the database of the master trainers which will be undergoing the training, and we will also upload it in the national portal of the STPRI. And this database of Orissa has already been compiled, and we have actually uploaded it in our website of the SEST RBI. Along with it, sir, as you have directed, we have also compiled this videos of the various themes which will be covered under this 4 days training program. Mm-hmm. And we have also uploaded it in the YouTube channel, which has been dedicatedly made for this training program. That is STPRI_training_Odisha. And we will be also discussing this with our participants in the course of our training. And we will be briefing how to access those training materials which are uploaded in the website as well as in the YouTube. Along with it, sir, we are also developing this customized training modules, which will be like tutorial videos, and those videos also we will be circulating across with all our participants, so that the STPRI members, when they will undergo the training, sir, as you have directed, they will try that they will have this access to this training or this tutorial videos as well. Thank you, sir. And now I would request Madam Ranjana Chopra, Principal Secretary, ST and SC Development Department, to kindly deliver her address. Madam Chopra.
Joint Secretary, Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Dr. Navaljeet Kapoor, Dr. Ota, Director SAST RTI, Director ST Guha Poonam Tapas Kumar, the officers of the Department of ST and SC Development Department who are at the district level, the master trainers of this program, representatives from the civil society, members of academia, and all the other resource persons who are with us in the program today. Let me add a very warm welcome from my side also to Dr. Kapoor, and thank him for considering Orissa as a pilot state. As Dr. Ota was mentioning, in February 2020, the All India program for the STPRIs was launched in Orissa. And we take great pride in the fact that most of the flagship programs of the ministry have been piloted in the state and have been successfully implemented in the state. Now, we have a lot of hopes and expectations from this program. I would like to give my own perspective as to why I think that this program is very important. You see, in case you look at the development landscape, one piece, that in the non-tribal areas, I'm talking specifically for about Orissa, that in case you come to the coastal Orissa and Orissa away from the tribal areas, one finds that the government intervention is much more visible than in the tribal pockets. The reason behind this is not that government has not been putting in money in the tribal areas. The main reason behind this is that the awareness levels of the people and people's representatives is very high. When the awareness level of the people's representatives become high in the community, people's representatives are an extension of the community. When their awareness level becomes high, then they start demanding their entitlements from the government setup. And when the demand for the entitlement of the population starts happening, then the scheme's implementation also starts improving on its own. The representatives of the government become more accountable. The governance system becomes more transparent, and the overall administration improves in that area. So hence, it is very important that the community is aware of their entitlements, the community's representatives are aware of the entitlements, and that they should be able to demand this from the government machinery. Now, the second reason why it is important is that in Orissa, we find that 22.5 or close to 23% of our population is tribal. We cannot talk of holistic development of Orissa unless and until there is a socio-economic development of the tribal families, the tribal households. The overall Orissa economic growth cannot happen unless and until there is an adequate economic development in the tribal areas of our state and in the households of our state. When we talk of poverty alleviation, when we talk of increasing the household income, when we talk of doubling the agricultural income, this none of these targets can be achieved unless and until there is a special focus on the tribal areas and the tribal communities. The third important reason or the importance of this training is that in the recent few years, especially in the last 4 or 5 years, one is finding that a lot of money has started flowing both from Government of India and from the state governments towards the tribal areas and towards the tribal projects. So it is important that this money is channelized in a productive manner and that a good developmental works are taken up and that the people are benefited at the end of it. Now, having said so, let me also give a caveat to our master trainers that I completely agree with Dr. Kapoor when he said that the program has to be made interactive, it has to be made more participating, the program is interesting, it should garner the attention of the audience. But more importantly, but besides this, I think it is also important for our master trainers to keep in mind that the tribal communities of today are not the tribal communities 20 years back. A lot of development, lot of improvement, lot of awareness generation has already happened. So I think we should also not be underestimating the knowledge and the awareness of our tribal communities. Now, as Dr. Ota was giving a brief note or context of the program, I was reminded of an incident when I had just joined service. I was working in Koraput district. I'm talking about 96, 97. And I remember when we would go to the villages, we would ask people that whom would you vote in elections? So keep in mind, it is 1996. So we would ask them that whom will you vote? So they will say that we will vote to the hand. We will give vote to hand. Hand meaning the Congress party. So then when asked, why will you give vote to the hand? Then they would say, because Indira Gandhi is our leader. Not knowing that Indira Gandhi has died 12 years back and that she is no longer there. But last year in February, when we had the inaugural program for the PRI workshop, it was so heartening to see the STPRI members who had come for that workshop, how aware they were of the programs, of the government, of their entitlements, of the government processes. Majority of them, in fact, most of them were not only literate, but well-educated, had gone to schools, had gone to colleges, had a good idea of what is happening in the world, were fluent in many languages, not only in the tribal language, could understand Hindi, could understand English, could understand Uriya. So they were already multilingual, the representatives who had come. So when the master trainers, when you will be imparting the training, I think you should keep in mind that the times have changed and a lot of awareness has already come in our tribal communities. Now it is high time that we build on this and we build on this structure and make them more aware. The more aware they are of the government programs and processes, the better will be our service delivery, because then the administration will become more transparent and accountable to its target audience. So with this, I once again congratulate Dr. Ota and his team of SCST RTI for having conceptualized this entire program, for having taken this program step by step and every time evolving, improving the program, collaborating with Mota so successfully and developing such comprehensive modules and teaching material. So I think the team has been working very hard. And with this program, I see that in the coming 1 year, not only the tribal communities will become aware of the government programs, I also see a beginning of a much better governance system in the tribal areas, where the administration will become accountable to its people. And then, you know, it will almost be like a dominoes effect or a cascading effect, where you will just sow the seeds of awareness among the STPRI members, and then gradually it will spread to the communities, and the communities at large will become more aware of their rights and their entitlements. I would also like to thank Mota for having supported this initiative financially and also technically. I am sure that this is going to be a very successful program, and that what is happening in Orissa will also become a roadmap for the rest of the states in the country. Thank you very much.
Your enlightening words. We always look forward to your kind guidance and working under your leadership. Now, as we come towards the end of this inaugural session, I would request Madam Poonam Guha, Director, STSC Development Department, to kindly give the vote of thanks.
Good morning. Respected Joint Secretary, Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Navaljit Kapoor, sir. Respected Principal Secretary, Ranjana Chopra, ma'am. Respected Director and Special Secretary, SCST RTI, Dr. A.B. Ota, sir. It gives me immense pleasure to be here this morning and propose a formal vote of thanks on this very auspicious occasion of the training of master trainers on capacity building of elected representatives belonging to the scheduled tribes. As we all know, the Panchayati Raj institutions play a pivotal role in development of society at the grassroots level. In particular, these institutions do play an important role in tribal development across the state. Therefore, capacity building of all these STPRI members is a noble initiative that will definitely bring visible and sustainable changes across the socio-economic and the cultural administrative panorama and the development of the tribal areas. Towards this, I once again wish to thank profusely Sir Navaljit Kapoor for taking out time from his busy schedule in launching this program today. And we will definitely take up the points that sir has mentioned, especially with respect to the IEC material, the database of the master trainers, and also to see to it that the various schemes and programs do reach the tribal PRI members effectively. And we will ensure that this is done in letter and spirit. I once again thank sir for his gracious presence here. Secondly, I would also like to thank Principal Secretary Ranjana ma'am for her benevolence and for always being a strong source of inspiration and support to us in all programs. And today her motivation will further drive us towards the tribal development in the state. And of course, I need not mention the contribution of Dr. A.B. Ota towards the tribal development programs that he has been spearheading from time to time. And this is definitely a very big step that we have been taking in the capacity building of the tribal PRI members. which will definitely show and has also been showing in the educational, in the socio-economic, in the cultural parameters of tribal development across the state of Odisha. So thank you so much, Dr. A.B. Ota, for this excellent initiative and for collaborating with all concerned towards this very important venture. As we all know, be the change you want to see in the world is something that Mahatma Gandhi had told us. And I believe that this particular workshop today will act as that change agent that will bring about cascaded development in the area of tribal development across the state of Odisha. So with this, I thank everybody for being here, for their kind words of motivation, and for being the driving change in this entire edifice. Thank you so much.
Thank you everybody for being here. And particularly, I again, thank Dr. Kapoor for her benign presence despite a very busy schedule. Thank you.
पार्टिसिपेंट्स जो माने अछंती मु काइंडली ताकु रिक्वेस्ट करबी कि आपन मीटिंग छाडी कि जानतु नहीं हमें 5 मिनट्स से 5 मिनट भितरे हमें पूर्ण स्टार्ट करबो हमर एक्चुअल सेशन जोटा कि पंचायती राज इंस्टीट्यूशंस ऊपर आज ही हाफ डे हमरो रहइबो आ 5 मिनट्स परे मु आपन को आई टेक यू थ्रू टू ऑल द द थीम्स द सेशंस जोटा कि हमें कवर करबो ई 4 दिन ट्रेनिंग भितरे सो काइंडली रिक्वेस्ट कि आपन काइंडली मीटिंग लीव करंतु नहीं थैंक यू के एस आई आर डी